Welcome friends, let's start with reactive intermediate part 2. So here we have given like a bromo and OMe is there. So we have given LDA. So what is the role of LDA? One equivalent LDA. So it will abstract acidic proton. So where is the acidic proton? So it will be this one. This one will be acidic proton because it is adjacent to bromine. So LDA will abstract this acidic proton. Right. So what happens then? Since bromine is a good leaving group, so this lone pair pushes here and leads to formation of a benzyne intermediate. Right. That's formation of a benzyne intermediate. Now we have this nucleophile. So it can either attack over here or it can attack over here. Right. So if it attacks here, if it attacks this position, then there will be a negative charge over here. Fine. And if it attacks here, then the negative charge will be in this position. Now we have to predict which negative charge is more stabilized. Okay. So now OMe has a minus I effect. So if a minus I effect group is adjacent to negative charge, that can stabilize it. Right. So if the negative charge is adjacent to an electron withdrawing group, that negative charge will be more stable. So this nucleophile will attack over here, and there will be a formation of negative charge adjacent to OMe group, right? So if our nucleophile, say CO2Me attacks here, and this negative charge will come here, right? So what will be the product? So this is COOME, this is CO2ME, this is OME, we have a negative charge. So this is basically A, right? Now what happens? This A star group is close to this negative charge. So it can easily attack here. Right. If it attacks here, then what happens? Attacks here. This is the O minus. This is the OME. And this is a CO2. Right. Now there are two possibilities now. Either this electron cloud comes here and leaves the OME, or this electron cloud comes here and this bond breaks and there is a formation of negative charge over here. Which one will go? As it's a four member ring, so it's not so much stable. So there is a cleavage of this four member ring. Let's say cleave this four member ring and negative charge over here, right? So the product comes out to be, here we have CO2Me, right? And here we have CO2Me and negative charge. And see, this negative charge is stable here because we have an adjacent electron withdrawing group. CO2Me is an electron withdrawing group, and the negative charge is adjacent to it. So it can stabilize this negative charge, right? So now doing the workup, if you work up this then with acid, then this will be protonated and this leads to the product. So this is the product, right? Now let's move to the second one. And one thing, if you have a problem in benzene intermediate, then just drop me a message in the comment box so that I will make some extra videos on Benzene, on full Benzene intermediate, right? Okay. Let's do the second one. We have a cyclohexanone substituted and we have given LDA. So LDA is a base, is a hindered base, right? So it will abstract a proton from the less hindered side. So there are two possibilities, either abstraction of proton from this side or from this side. But here we have a methyl group. So it's a hindered. So it will take up the proton from the less hindered side. LDA will take up the proton from the less hindered side. So there will be a negative charge. Next we have given pH acetyl. Phenyl selenium bromide. So what it will form? So it's, let's say Br. So this one will attack over here and bromine lips, right? So this leads to formation of ACPH. Okay. Now we have given H2O2. What is H2O2? It's an oxidizing agent. So H2O2 will oxidize this selenium. To form this one, right? So what is this basically? This is this one. This one is basically like this. You can write it like this. Okay. Now what will happen? This will abstract this proton. This is a concerted mechanism, and this is one type of syn elimination, right? So it will abstract this proton. It will form a double bond, and it will go over here. Fine. So we are getting alpha beta unsaturated ketone plus pH ACH. So this is our product. Fine. Okay. Now the next part, last problem of video, that is again we have LDA. Now we have this intermediate. Right, so we have LDA, so it will abstract a proton. From where it will abstract? And here there is no proton, here there is no proton, and this proton are not acidic, so this is slightly acidic. So LDA will abstract a proton from here. So here there will be a negative charge in presence of LDA, right? Now what happens, this one will attack here. This will go here and this one moves, right? So there is a formation of 5 member ring. So there is a formation of a 5 member ring with like a pH over here, let's say number 1 2 3 4 5, like a 1 2 3 4 5. So 2 and 3, there is a double bond. There is a double bond in between 2 and 3, and in 3 there is a O TMS group, right? So we have a O TMS group over here. Now what happens in presence of if you hydrolyze this, so this will form alcohol. If you hydrolyze this, it will form alcohol, and this will undergo ketoanion tautomerism to form a ketone over here, right? So what happens? We have a pH and we have a, so I'm writing it over here, let's same, yes, okay, ketone, right? Now we have given MCBP. So what MCBP does? It will undergo Bayer-Villiger oxidation, right? So if it undergo Bayer-Villiger oxidation, there are two groups which can migrate. One is this carbon can migrate, or this can migrate. So this is a tertiary one, and this is secondary. So tertiary will migrate. So the oxygen will be in between this bond. So it will be like a ketone. We are forming this one. So this undergo Bayer-Villiger oxidation, right? So this is how you have to do this type of thing. Just think and do. Just if you have LDA, just think which proton will have struck. Then if you have MCBA, there is a sure shot either there. If there is a double bond, then there is a chance of epoxidation. If there is no double bond, if it's a ketone, then just do straightforward. Think about bi-reject oxidation. So in the upcoming videos, I will keep on uploading more and more examples of reaction intermediate. So that's all for the video. So hope you like the video. Thank you very much.